Greetings. Well, I had a nifty clever analogy ready to talk about in part two, but I honestly have no peace in my heart to make light of the most serious topic I can imagine. The annihilation of more than half, no, the vast majority of all mankind. Yeah, that kind of wipes the grin off of my face. You see, there is only one hope for mankind, but it does not result in things going back to the way they were. The only hope is to see the cancer and recognize it was foretold, and seek the guidance of the God who has warned us of the cancer. Even the world knows that something is happening, about like a blind man who can smell the smoke and feel the heat, and know there is a dangerous fire somewhere near him, but all he can do is wonder which way is safe to run. And even hearing that truth, the liberals who see this will be forced by their conditioning to focus about how enabled and equal blind people are. You see, there are many forms of blindness, all of them disabling in the loss of ability to perceive reality. We fool ourselves that at 40 we are as good as we were at 30, and at 50 we fool ourselves that we're as strong as we ever were at 40. And perhaps in one way or another you have improved through discipline and effort. But if you refuse to see that you are closer to death than you were 10 or 20 years earlier, you truly are just lying to yourself. And what does that have to do with the cancer of part one?
That is the sound of inevitability.
The world of science, the world of freedom, the world of technology, the world of safety, the world of peace. The cancer seeks to destroy all of that, my friend. And the cancer is unstoppable. The cancer is unstoppable because the only solution is unthinkable. Even the usage of three simple words will cause a visceral repulsion, and rightly so. The final solution. The very words are repulsive to me. I cannot imagine the stiffening reaction that anyone of Hebrew descent feels when they hear those evil words. And to be absolutely clear, the solution I refer to is to stop the Islamic cancer. And it is because civilized and rational men cannot consider any such final solution that the course of humanity is set in ever-hardening concrete. There is no solution good and moral, rational men can consider. Islam is a cancerous religion, in every sense of the word cancer. And God is going to give all men one final chance to join the cancer or reject submission to the cancer. God is going to allow the cancer to grow. God revealed almost 2,000 years ago just how far Islam would grow. And God revealed the Mahdi and his athletic supporter Issa. Only God called them the Antichrist and false prophet. And what God has foretold will happen. And bright people, smart people, liberals who think they know best will be utterly unable to even see the events happening as they go down. Don't think so? You only need to look back 1 week. Before the ambassador's body was cold, liberals were apologizing to the Mohammedans who committed murder. Disregard the fact it was Mohammedans who attacked and murdered the ambassador. The savage animals of Islam tossed out feigned offense at some YouTube video. Oh dear, I wonder if Muhammad's dancing demons will take offense at that. Our president and secretary Both apologized for the cancer being irritated and inflamed. I am surprised they did not blame the Tea Party and Rush Limbaugh and all Christians everywhere while they were busy kissing Mohammed's sphincter ring. But I digress. But imagine for the moment that liberals stop snorting cocaine and cow manure long enough to recognize the cancer. Even if liberals could begin a statement without first reflexively muttering, "War on women, war on women," sane and rational human beings cannot and should never consider final solutions. That literally is above Obama's pay grade and will remain so forever. So humanity is literally incapable of combating this cancer of Islam. Yet God has already foretold how He will treat the cancer. The cancer will, for a time, become very powerful. The cancer will grow and have power to kill healthy cells. Many will mutate and submit and join the cancer. But while that seems a valid strategy at the time, it will prove to be a fatal decision. But when the Lord Jesus returns, He will forever remove the cancer with the sword of His mouth. Revelations, verse 15, "And out of His mouth proceedeth a sharp sword, that with it He should smite the nations. And He shall rule them with a rod of iron, and He treadeth the winepress of the fierceness of the wrath of God the Almighty. And I saw the beast and the kings of the earth and their armies gathered together to make war against Him that sat upon the horse, Jesus, and against His army. And the beast, Antichrist, Mati, was taken, and with him the false prophet, Issa of Islam, that wrought the signs in his sight, wherewith he deceived them that had received the mark of the beast and them that worshipped his image. They too were cast alive into the lake of fire that burns with brimstone. And the rest were killed with the sword of him that sat upon the horse, even the sword which came forth out of his mouth, and all the birds were filled with their flesh." The rest. Do you understand what the rest means? You see, when the Lord Jesus returns, it will not be with shouts of Allahu Akbar. It will be to remove all of the cancer. All who follow the Antichrist. All who follow Islam. Every last cell. And it does not matter why you hate the truth. If you hate the truth, you hate Jesus Himself. You hate the God who is truth. And the only ones left will be healthy cells who love the truth. And please do not think you will change or convert or repent at the last second. Because the words "too late" will loom very large in the near future. 2 Thessalonians 2:7. "For the mystery of lawlessness does already work, only there is one that restrains now until he be taken out of the way. And then shall be revealed the lawless one, whom the Lord Jesus shall slay with the breath of his mouth and bring to naught by the manifestation of his coming. Even he whose coming is according to the working of Satan, with all power and signs and lying wonders, and with all deceit of unrighteousness for them that perish, because they received not the love of the truth, that they might be saved." Allow that judgment to sink in, my friend. They received not the love of the truth. They rejected the love of the truth, that they might be saved by it. If they loved the truth, they would be saved by that love of the truth. And for this cause, what cause? This cause, they received not the love of the truth, that they might be saved? And for this cause God shall send them strong delusion, that they should believe a lie, that they all might be damned who believed not the truth, but had pleasure in unrighteousness. This is one of those terrifying verses that reveal God will not always suffer your rebellion. Whatever the strong delusion is, and I have my theory, when it occurs, time is essentially up for you. Your ability to hear and receive truth will have been blocked.
Denied.
So please, decide now whether you have any regard for the truth, while you still may. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.